planned this 6,000-mile cross-country trip to camp and ride the trails of Colorado and Utah. I traveled alone from Miami, Florida, across the southern states to Texas, then up through New Mexico, and finally arriving in Silverton, Colorado, where I made my base camp at the Mineral Creek camping area. Base camp was next to the creek with spectacular views of the mountains. The plan was to enjoy many of the mountain passes that this area offers. Unfortunately, some areas were closed due to snow-covered roads. Yes, in mid-June, but I was able to do many of the trails that I love. Next, it was on to Moab, Utah, to camp in the deserts and explore some of the passes there. Then I would take I-70 returning on a northern path to visit Kansas, have some Missouri barbecue in St. Louis, then explore the river roads of Tennessee. Part 1 will cover just the Colorado experience.
Where am I? In the middle of fucking nowhere.
While driving through New Mexico, I came across this accident. It was a truck that was pulling a trailer and a pontoon boat. Way too much weight, and kind of dangerous to do if you don't know what you're really doing. So be careful when you're trailering out there. Make sure everything is up to spec and within the capacity of your vehicles. Looked like nobody was hurt, thank God. Just past Durango, pulled over to the road to watch the amazing landscapes, take some pictures. After 3 days of travel, this is the result of that's Silverton right there, you can see to the left, and I'm just pulling into town. I'm not going to go into town right away, I'm actually going to go find a camping spot. I want to get it done before nighttime. And now, to Mineral Creek Campground. It should be right up this road. To find the campsite.
Well, I've reached Mineral Creek campsite, campground or camp area, and now it's just a matter of finding a nice camping site. I want to try to be close to the river so I can hear the river. So I got here, it's 5:30, there's still a few hours of sunlight, so I have plenty of time to set up camp. I just gotta figure out where that's gonna be.
Well, I think I found the perfect tent site. Right next to the road and right on the river. I have a natural table for cooking and put my stuff right on there. I have a burn pit. Thank you. This is the spot.
First night at the tent on the campsite, it was a little cold, down in the 30s. I have good insulation and bedrolls and such as that, so I wasn't cold. I was a little uncomfortable because of the pillow that I brought sinks a little bit into my cot. So I'm going to see if I can find a better pillow or find something to prop under it so my head won't be like that down. Other than that, it was a good night. Slept well. This morning has been beautiful. I took a walk earlier, took some pictures at sunrise, and found some. There's a family of rabbits right across from the stream from me, just running around having a good time. Yesterday I saw a couple deer. I was able to take a picture with my other camera. So, hopefully I see more wildlife.
This is Clear Creek Falls, and it was super cluttered with wood and debris.
Well, just did a little hike to see the waterfall. It's over here. There's a little trail that goes down, and there's a waterfall that comes down back there. It was beautiful, unbelievable. This is the not really a waterfall, but just I guess the. Sure, there's a waterfall, but there's no access to it, and I'm too old to start hiking up there. But I did hike the other one, the easier trail.
So this is the trail that goes to Mineral Creek Falls. It's a brisk 10-minute hike up to the creek, and then you can actually see the waterfall. And it's a pretty stunning view for where it is. This is the way back. Took a slightly different path back to the road to get
here. We go. This is put you back up there, and off we go.
there's still some snow up here. I saw a little bit of snow walking through the, there's a little bit. It's starting to melt off. I think I want to climb on ice. Looks like a not very fun time. So this is the end. Quick little turnaround there. Okay, so this is the Clear Lake Road. And goes up into the middle of the mountains through a couple of switchbacks and ends up in a beautiful lake. So, really looking forward to that.
This one's going to be very capable 4x4 to come up here. Start current. Oh, that would be easier.
First cut back here.
stop and enjoy this view for a second. So from here, you can see right there. See that? That's where I was had to stop because of the avalanche snow from the avalanche covering that road.
So well above where I was before.
Onward. To the gauge on my truck, it says it's 55 degrees right here where we're at. Last night it went down to 30. Like at 3 in the morning, it was cold as hell. Had to throw on an extra layer. So the top, so they start getting a little tighter. The locker's kicking in, and boom, over the top. Here. somebody behind me. I was in a rush. Nobody wants to take the time and do things slowly and enjoy the scenery. Campground up here at the top.
What? Did I just get signal?
At the top of the mountain, I got signal. That's crazy. I hadn't had signal in a while.
Howdy.
Hey, we got that's the end of the road. It's impassable from here.
So. Well, I thought they said we could make it to the lake today.
Say what?
I thought they said that we could make it to the lake.
Yeah, unfortunately. We got a car there, and then I just walked it a little bit.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take off my little thing and see if we can swing around. Look, there's not really a whole ton of space, but just figured I'd give you a heads up before you got up there.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Well, as far as we get with the cars, so gonna hike the rest of the way. Not gonna film this because I'm too old to film and walk and try to breathe up here. So I'll give you some highlights from here to there. Well, I've hiked not even a quarter mile and I'm dying. My goal is to get up to that waterfall. Hopefully I don't die before then. Well, made it to the waterfall. It's quite nice. I'm done hiking. I'm not going up there. There's a lake up there, supposedly, you could see. But yeah, I'm too out of shape for that. So at least I got here where I wanted to get. Now I gotta walk all the way back downhill. Coming down from the Crystal Lake that I wasn't able to see. Piece of wood there. Looks like that could slide down if anybody were to hit it. So let's make sure I don't hit it. Well, got a flat tire. It's on the sidewall, so I can't patch it. I have to change out the tire. I heard an elk bugle just now. I Oh well, here we go.
Well, I got my spare tire on. A little help from a family that came by in a Jeep, and got the spare in. Now I gotta go find the tire because I don't have another spare. So the adventures continue.
There was no tires my size in the garage in Silverton, so I had to drive about 60 miles to Montrose, Colorado, where there's a Walmart Supercenter. And I did call ahead, and they had five tires my tire size. And I drove up. When I got there, they told me, oh yeah, we have your tires, but you'll have to wait till tomorrow morning to get them installed. So I opted to stay in a motel there at Montrose till the morning and get them installed and head back to my camp that morning. Wasted 2 days, now back to our regularly scheduled trip.
This is part of the Alpine Loop. Some of the most beautiful views I've seen yet. Snow puts a beautiful accent on everything. Taking this moment to take a picture of the truck next to the snowbanks. Love my AT4, baby. Softer than I thought it was. I thought it was going to be hard, but nope, it's pretty soft. All right.
around. There we go. Snowman or something. Oops. Oh, I should have paused for that photo break. Glad to take the time to clear this road. This is pretty freaking cool. Wind is whipping. Look at that shit. This is amazing. Taking a selfie. Selfie! You guys think, is this place cool or what? Look at the color of that mountain. The red in the mountain comes from the iron deposits that are in the soil, and as it comes up and it gets air, it rusts and it turns everything red. Picture. All right, back in and continue the journey. gonna go up here to the left, and if it's open, seatbelt on. As brave as I am, it's still a little scary up here.
The road to the pass was blocked and been plowed all the way through, so this is as far as I was going to get. So turn around and head back and try to find another way back down the mountain. There was many roads, so there was no shortage of ways to go.
Yeah, a little scary, especially since I'm all alone. All right, picture time. Well, the road isn't passable, so I turn around. It's a shame. But better safe than sorry. Go back down the way we came. A steep little drop here. Corkscrew Gulch, that's what this place is called, Corkscrew Gulch. Time to bring my mirror in again. This is a good spot for a picture of how close I am to the edge. Continue. Little snow. It's not snowing. I'm grabbing it off the side here. And oops, got some in the car. Yay, snowing. I get that shit off there. All right, here we go. Hear the breeze, the wind going through the trees.
Come on, blow again.
Nope, not gonna do it for me. It's 6 o'clock, so after this run, I'm gonna head back to camp. I really don't want to get stuck out here in the dark, even though it gets dark here on 8:30. But better safe than sorry. I really don't have lights adequate for being off-road. I just have the vehicle lights. Tilting up and looking down as far as I can. I can't imagine people who have their trucks super lifted coming through here not being able to see. Even though I could see with my camera, but the camera doesn't stay on all the time, only when I activate it. Ooh, slow down, baby. Seen any elk. I heard some elk bugling yesterday, right about the time I popped my tire. But that's it. I saw a couple deer. It was at nightfall, and I got some really grainy pictures of them. That since it's a park, there's an outhouse in the middle of nowhere. Probably because if you stop here to take a picture and you hear that little brook next door, it makes you want to go to the bathroom. Taking a couple pictures. Going down, temperature's 56 degrees. It was a little colder up top, but not much more. I guess that's why the snow's melting.
Alpine tundra. So some marmots up top, and a flight bird didn't fly, just ran around. Well, could fly, but didn't look like it was going anywhere. Not sure what kind of bird it is, but you're going to look back. I should first get this altitude. Struggling up here with seat heaters and such. Back up to that's a bye-bye. Next stop, recording. Oh yeah, easy, easy. Just rolling downhill. Go back that way, hasn't been cleared. Huh. Ooh, it's gone. It goes up a bit.
Windshield is fogging. Let's put a little heat on it. There's so many trails out here to explore. Different way down. I didn't take the same way that I came up.
Hopefully it goes through. I don't want to have to turn around. Oh, this goes down along the river. So cool. Right. Water crossing. Water's moving kind of quickly, so I'm going to try to get right across this thing. Not dilly-dally. There you go. That was pretty cool. I hit the shift lever with my hand, so I came out of gear right as I was crossing it. But not too bad. Let me go take some pictures.
Apparently, the wind blows you at a certain elevation. Because you really don't see below and you don't see above. A certain elevation is going to be below. Pretty weird. Still a pole, that's always a good thing. Side going back to the substation. That's where we came. Way down there. That's where we came in that way. So, this left goes up the mountain, back and up, and back. This left goes up to a lake, and then it ends. Check this.
Left of mining operation.
All right. So we need to turn.
Some type of mining operation, I guess, that's working.
Driving into the sun, and we've already seen this road on the way in, so I'm gonna go ahead and end this here. On our way back to camp.
A few deer there. Just grazing in the grass.
Meet up, boys and girls. Just relaxing after a long day of getting tires, driving around, going up to the passes. Now just here to relax a little bit and have a beer. Made myself a sandwich, not eating anything elaborate today, tonight. It's getting a lot colder. It's about 40 degrees right now, and it's expected to get down into the mid-30s, low-30s overnight. Starting to pick up. Leaving Colorado and heading towards Utah, but before I do that, I must make myself some coffee. Alright, all picked up. Last minute policing of the grounds. Make sure I didn't leave any little papers or... I'm missing a battery, hopefully I find it. One of my camera batteries, but... Picking up stuff so I can throw it away. Always leave the campsite better than you found it. I am leaving Colorado and heading towards Moab. It's about approximately 175 miles. It takes me about 3.5 hours. And I'll figure out what I do there. In any case, that will be on my next video, part 2, Moab, Utah. I want to thank you for watching. If you've stayed this long, it's a long video. If you've stayed this long, I invite you to watch the next one. And like, subscribe, and share. Thank you again.
Of war. I can't stop the dogs of war.